reason. Chris thinks he's free right now. So Chris and I are new roommates.
I live with him.
Only one person was okay with that. Everyone else is like, no, they shouldn't. They shouldn't live together.
It's because your shirt's too tight. They're judging us.
I made it funny.
We doubled our wardrobe by living together. But I don't know. I want to make it weird for him. So we tour separately. He's performed in all 50 states. I've performed in 45, so I'm not as good as him. But one thing I like to do is when I know we have a show together is kind of find a way to mess with Chris. So this is called the Stand Up and Knock Out Show. Is it kind of clever? Is it stand up and hypnotism? Did you guys get that?
Yeah.
Yeah. So like, yeah, all right, whatever. You guys are like, is that your first one? You just went with the first one you guessed? It's not our first idea. It took us a couple hours.
It took many hours.
Whatever.
We're not smart.
Yeah. And I decided to put together a PowerPoint presentation for you. I told you I was going to do something. I didn't tell you what it is. So these are all the... We had a photo shoot. His dad actually did the photo shoot. His dad took this photo. I think he just told me to do that.
My dad was like, why are we taking photos of hate crimes?
Chris, I was punching your white half. It doesn't count. You know who loved that joke? Brent and Ingrid, his parents. Which one's the white one?
Brent
or Ingrid? You guys are actually thinking, you're like,
Brent.
What was it?
Brent.
Yeah. Incorrect. No, I said which one's the white one?
Oh, the white one is Ingrid.
Did you forget?
Yeah,
did you? The concussion. So, I took some of the photos and we decided not to use and come up with the different titles that we could use for this show or some of the shitty ones that we had originally written. So, Chris, I hope this embarrasses you for the rest of your show. So, we have, here's a good one. Here are the alternate titles. Let's see. We have the Stand Up and Puss Out. He's laughing so genuinely as I was like, tapping him slightly. Okay. What else do we got? We have the stand down and give up. So we're just being friends. I didn't want him to punch me. I had a freak. It's the only thing you can fit in a boxing glove. There's like a little gap. Shut up. I know you guys are all out there.
You know what?
So nice you can do. Motion up the glove. I'm going 12 rounds. Oh no, knockout. You won. Really? Really? When you're boxing yourself, you're going to go 12 rounds? Who has that kind of time, okay?
That was a joke about
night out of it.
That was a joke about masturbating. Okay. I don't get it.
There's a reason I use innuendo, so the ones that get it, and the ones who shouldn't get to live in their little harmony. So. Alright, what else do we have? Here's some stay up and go down. And we have the Stand Still and Creep Out, our previous photo. By the way, you're wearing a shirt in this photo shoot, so.
Yeah, I understand.
Okay. And my tie.
Yeah.
All right. Then we have the Flip Off Workout. I couldn't show it. It's censored. Let's see. This we have Knocked Up.
That's just a story.
I know, but look at the seriousness of you. You're like.
Just like your baby. That's a big break album right there.
Way up.
Anyway. Blessed.
There's marshmallow and hot chocolate. He's marshmallow because he's soft and I'm hot chocolate.
See, yeah. It's a
boy
band.
Yeah. And then we have Two White Boys from Chicago Comedy Hour. I thought I'd go with that title. What was that? Something on your eyebrow?
You're number one.
Is there something on your eyebrow? And then we have Drake and Friends. That's our album cover, guys. This is going to be our album cover. Legit, while our friends are taking these photos, I was like, I'm going to make
what
the most emotional
to make that face, Adam.
I was like, if I was in a boy band in the 90s, how would would I want to face the camera while I look off in the distance and make women think that I'm thinking thoughts? That's why they always look off in the distance like, oh, and girls are like, what is he thinking? The answer is probably nothing. Or boobs, it's always boobs. Drake in front round two, and then this funny photo for no reason. And then the best photo of the night was Chris hops in between these bleachers. And he goes,
I still have legs, okay?
Just what happened to him? He hops in between the bleachers and he goes, look, I'm half black. And it's taken me some time, but I know how to reply to that. Yeah, from the waist up, right? I don't know. It's fun. I'm in Flint on purpose. All of you guys are here on purpose, right? You paid money to be in Flint, Michigan? I'm pretty sure people pay money to do the exact opposite. You know what they say? What happens in Flint? Question, what happens in Flint? You stay indoors, that's what you do. You don't cross the street. You guys are in your little safety nook. It's fine. It's fine. Ladies, can I yell at you for a moment? Is that okay?
No.
No? Alright, that's a question. On behalf of all the women, no. I have to yell at you ladies specifically, because it won't matter if I yell at the guys. So ladies, can you stop thinking we think thoughts? Because the problem is that you think that we think things and we didn't acknowledge the things that we thought when we never thought the thought in the first place. Right? All these girls nodding their heads, every guy in here had a fucking brain aneurysm.
Like, what are you? There are lots of words. What happened?
You this, okay? They're not gonna change. You have to do this. We don't think things, okay? Like, stop it. My mom asked my dad these impossible questions when I was visiting them for 4th of July. This is what she asked my dad. She was like, how did you not think of that? No, I need you to tell me exactly how you didn't think of it. And I just watched the fear grow in his eyes. Like, I'm supposed to explain the thought process that went into not having a thought process. I'm sorry, honey, I love you. You keep thinking we think thoughts. I can prove it. Ladies, how many of you in here have ever tried to drop a hint for a guy? A hint? Yeah? Collectively, just answer how it went in whatever terms you want to. How did that go? It did it! Don't drop a hint for a guy. This is how you drop a hint for a guy. First, you buy a billboard. Put your message on the billboard. Then buy a separate billboard across from that billboard. And tape him to it for a month. There's a 30% chance he reads it. And a 25% chance he thinks it applies to him. I could stare at a billboard for like a month and be like, Adam, put your socks in the hamper. Sucks for that guy, right? We don't know things. Stop thinking we know things. We just don't. Ladies, it's because you're just naturally better at some stuff than guys. Ladies, would you agree with me on that?
Yeah, everything.
Being humble, right? Especially this girl. She's like, everything, yeah. Don't yell at me. I would say you're better at some stuff. I say you're better at emotions. Would you agree with me on that? I got the full range of emotion on that answer. I mean that in a good sense. Like, your emotional vocabulary is better than ours. You can have multiple emotions at a time. Have you ever seen a guy have one emotion?
No.
We look like we're pooping, right?
I think it's love, or is it Chipotle? I don't know.
Which one gives you gas and has sofritas? Is that love? That's Chipotle. All right, I think I'm having an emotion, I'm not sure. But ladies, you know the combo, the combo. My sister is a professional at this. This is what she said the last time I saw my sister. You ready? I'm really happy how mad I'm about being sad right now. A couple of girls are nodding their heads. A lot of guys are just like, I blacked out a week ago. Just had a retroactive blackout. Lost a week of your life trying to... I'm really happy how mad I'm about being sad right now. She's like, well, yeah, you don't want to be happy about being sad, so I'm mad about being sad, so I'm happy about being mad about being sad. Do you understand? Is it Chipotle? I don't know. We don't know. This is what my sister said one time. This is for real. Okay, this is over Christmas. She goes, I'm really mad at how mad I'm about being mad right now. Isn't that called mad? She's like, no, I'm really mad how mad I'm about being mad right now. I was like, oh, that's much different. She's like, well, I'm annoyed about being pissed off about being perturbed when I should be, like, happy that I'm pissed off about being perturbed, but I'm angry about being annoyed about being pissed off about being perturbed. It makes me upset about being angry about being annoyed about being pissed off about being perturbed. Do you understand? Guys, I'm actually not alive after listening to that. My brain exploded. I don't understand it. We can't combine emotions, guys. Well, actually, you know what? There's one feeling that we can combine with anything. So it's like hungry. It's a type of hungry that starts with the same letter. Okay, what was your guess?
Horny.
Horny, that's right. I don't know why all the guys didn't chime in right away. Oh wait, I do. I know why, because you didn't understand that was an emotion or a feeling. You thought that was a perpetual state of being, didn't you? They're not even clapping. Their testosterone's just flowing. They don't even go, you're like, horny's that thing that's called being alive, right? Like, it ends when you're dead, like, that. You can combine any emotion or feeling with horny. Shout out any emotion or feeling.
Sad.
Sad horny? Yeah, that's real. It's like probably going to be most of your time here, because you're like, supply and demand, that's how it works here. What other emotions?
Angry.
Angry horny? Yeah, you got an anger boner? Good. Sad horny spills over an angry horny. What else?
Lonely.
Lonely horny? I think that's just called horny. That's just regular. What, anything else?
Tired.
Ooh, tired horny might be the only one we can't beat. You can't, right guys? If in any way you're turned on, you're not falling asleep. Ladies, you don't understand that you can actually be tired. Like, that's not a thing. If you say, oh, I'm tired, we just assume that means you don't want us. Because if we say, oh, we're tired, that means we don't want you physically. Sorry, sad truth? Okay, whatever. We can't be tired, horny, okay? It wakes up before us. Do you understand? Choose for that to be the case? No! It wakes up before me. I don't want that to happen. Do you know what I want to do when I wake up? Pee, like every morning. Do you know what I can't do when I wake up? Pee, like, it has to be a grace period, or I need to create a sky urinal. Okay? You guys are engineers, make one. That's why they call them cocks. They cock a little do it to crack a cock, okay? Talking biology here, all right? What other emotions or feelings? Yeah?
Confused.
Confused, horny? Yeah. It's a lot of the time. I'm not going to say specifically you, because that would be mean of me. All right, we're figuring it out. Good. But Confused Horny, yeah, we kind of just used the horny to be our guide, right?
Like, I don't know what to do, point me in the right direction, little buddy. He's always pointing north, he's my compass.
Any other emotions?
Disgusted.
Disgusted, horny? Yeah, you know what, that's real. Every guy in here's probably been like, yeah, it was really gross, I was still turned on. Like, it doesn't... Our bodies are screaming at us every time we wake up as a man, like, hey, reproduce! Do you remember reproduction? Don't forget about reproducing! Remember reproduction? You should do that! I don't want that. It's terrible. Have you guys been having fun so far? Enjoying yourselves? Make some noise. Because I have a couple ways I could go. Okay, so I could go the scripted route of, like, jokes that I know, or I could do this, which I have been doing. Where I don't know what you're gonna say to me. I don't know what I'm gonna say. We're gonna find out together. So make some noise if you want the scripted material. Make some noise. We do not trust my jokes, asshole. Make some noise if you want this. All right, this is gonna be our symbol. I'm trying this out. This is gonna be our symbol. Cool. You know what's funny is, ladies, I give you a lot of credit though, because like you have this awesome, if you haven't used this yet, you need to. It's this, it's like a Jedi mind trick of apology. It's where you like apologize, and in the end, we feel like we owe you an apology. Like I had somebody say this to me before, I had a girl go, I'm sorry that my emotions are such an inconvenience for you. I was like, I'm an asshole, baby, I'm sorry. Wait, how did you do that? This is not the apology you're looking for. You should have let us pass. That's funny. There's a lot of miscommunication with my woman. I think it's because, like, we vent differently. Like, when guys vent, we vent to strategize. But I was like, dude, my roommate keeps eating all my cereal. What might you say in response?
Steal it.
Steal it, hide your cereal, punch him in the face, pee his bed. You all gave me solutions when I presented you with a problem. And I'm not mad at you for that. But ladies, when you vent, you just want to
talk,
vent, yell, get it out. Which is confusing to us because the way that we're wired, we are calculator people. You type in a problem, hit enter, solution comes out. That's it. Or error message. That's it. There's a lot of miscommunication that happens. And it's because we don't really contain the ability to just vent and become okay with anything. So I'm going to need a male volunteer. This is a terrible idea, but I'm going to need a male volunteer to help me exemplify this point. Do we got anybody? This guy is super excited. You want to come up?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, all right. He's real excited.
Yeah, Christian.
All right, what's your name?
Christian,
give it up for Christian, everybody. Please also give it up for all the other religions and atheism. So can we do that? All right. You seem really excited, now you're afraid. Okay. Say hi to Christian class.
Hi, Christian.
I was wondering if they know how to do that. It was like, you guys went back to third grade, you're like, hi, Christian. It's cross applesauce. Like, he's the new kid. Okay. So we're going to role play. Who says crisscross applesauce? People from other schools? I don't know.
The school I was in was the only school that ever existed.
What did you call it? Person that heckled, what did you call it? You can answer. You can answer, I'm asking you.
Yeah, no, she was talking to me, I didn't hear the question.
Oh, okay. What did you call it? Because I called it crisscross applesauce because that was cuter. What did you call it when you sat like this?
I have no idea.
Indian style.
Indian style, huh? Maybe I wanted to update it for 2015. Thank you. What?
But I didn't call it that.
What? You didn't call it anything. Apparently, you don't understand when to talk or when not to, so. Instead of like asking a friend, you're like, hold on, I'm gonna pause the show for me. What just happened up there? I appreciate that. I'm not joking when I say that. I like that. You guys are being very respectful. You're here, you're present. Also, I think you have terrible cell service in this place, but it doesn't matter. Alright. Thank you for standing here. Okay. So we're gonna role play.
Okay.
You're gonna be me, and I'm gonna be every girl I've ever dated. This guy's like, he's gonna be two women. No, this isn't your fault, this isn't my fault, this is just how we communicate differently, okay? So just respond like you normally would, or just, okay, don't worry about it, it'll be fine. All right. You would not believe this, Adam, this is ridiculous. What is 2 + 2? 4? This is not about 4. Can you, no, don't laugh in my face. Can you not give me solutions every time I try to talk to you about what is 2 + 2? This is ridiculous. Like, I just need you to be there for me. If you love me, just listen to me say, what is 2 + 2? 4. 4? You're just gonna keep doing that, huh? You're just gonna know better than me. I'm the one that had to deal with it this way, and when you give me solutions, it makes me feel like my emotions are invalid. And I just want you to be there for me. If you love me, just listen to me say, what is 2 + 2? 5? Listen to me say, what is 2 + 2?
I don't know at this point. I want to go home.
So every time I try to talk to you, you just want to be let go. Huh? That's what you want to do? Fine, I'll let you go. We're broken up. Stay here. We're broken up. You, sir, do not leave my ex. He's such a dick, right? You understand me. If you love me, just listen to me say, what is 2 + 2?
I'm sorry.
He said, I'm sorry. Give him a huge round of applause. Yes. Alright. Is it your fault? Alright. Come here a little bit. Now, there are, when a woman's venting to you, guys, take this lesson to heart. When a woman's venting to you, there are 3 correct solutions. Okay? It doesn't matter that we're calculators, they press 2 + 2, hit enter, you cover up 4. When a woman is venting to you, there are 3 correct solutions. Correct answer number 1, you just say, I'm sorry, I'm there for you. Good. Correct answer number 2, you just repeat it back to him. You go, what do you think 2 + 2 is? Good. And correct answer number 3, it's the most fun. Guys, you make this sound, you go, ah. And then you say this, you go, ah. That bitch, and it just works. That bothered you recently at all? Anything at all? Traffic, roommates, laundry, homework?
Cell service?
What a bitch, right? You felt like I connected to you? I didn't. I just said what I needed to. Okay, I had an equation, and X is whatever you said, and I put it into there. Give me something else that bothered you.
My mom died today.
What a bitch. Now, if that is true, we will both spontaneously combust. Okay, so now, okay, we're back together, right? Don't worry about that thing. That didn't even count, whatever. I was at a party, you were like, in Indiana, it doesn't matter. Okay, yeah, we're back together. Now you understand me. If you love me, just listen to me say, what is 2 + 2? Fuck that bitch. Pause on the F as the 4 almost came out. Did you notice that? Were you about to say it? It's like, fuck that bitch, good job. Give him a huge round of applause. Thank you, guys. See? That's how slow of learners we are. Even after teaching him 3 answers, he still almost said a 4.
He's a math major.
That's great. This is really fun. There's been a lot of this today. I'm gonna get a lot of that. Oh man. I have a gift for you, Christian.
Oh.
It's a slap on koozie.
My
opinion. So, it's a koozie. Slap on. Put your right name on it. It can fit everything. Yeah. Don't worry, people that work here, it can go on water and other things. It's a koozie. All right. I once had school in Connecticut. I was drinking, and I was like, okay, that's fine. Except the fact that I was doing a show in their campus center building, and in the venue, they sold alcohol to the students. Nobody else finds it like, really, don't give them a koozie because it promotes cold beer. We would like to sell them alcohol to their face holes. But please don't let them keep their water cold. Okay. Yeah, I know, it's kind of stupid. All right. What else should we talk about? God. Do you guys do that annoying thing in a text message where you repeat the last letter a bunch for emphasis?
Yeah.
Like, yes. And your next text is can you just pay attention to the letters you do it with? Okay, pay attention to the letters, say them out loud. Because my cousin's 18, she never pays attention. She sent me what with a bunch of T's. She was like, what? Isn't the what roller coaster? What? This will be fun. Guys, Oh, no. You ever go out to dinner with a girl and hear her?
Hey, the answer is no. Nope. Joke over.
That's really funny. Alright, you ever just been around a girl at dinner? And hear her make a noise for the dessert that she's never made for you? Just in general? Well, okay, this happened to me, and I was like, I took a drop, and for dessert, you ready? She got salted caramel creme brulee. Did you hear those involuntary noises? Who did they come from? Women, I'm sorry. Oh, and the ones that didn't make a sound, you were just waiting for me to say your food, right? Was it cheesecake? Or some of you are like, if he says peanut butter right now, I'm gonna lose my shit. Red velvet cake, what is it? What do you guys, did I not get it? What?
Chocolate.
Chocolate, just chocolate in general? This girl's like. I love it, ask a girl about her favorite food. She will look off in the distance and have a moment. What's your favorite dessert?
Chocolate mousse.
She had it. She had it picked up. Chocolate mousse. And I love it. I love it when my friends, their girls, they get a little defensive about it. They're like, I'm like, yeah, I like chocolate mousse too. And they're like, no. Not the way I do. Like, if we both tried to date chocolate mousse, then you would totally win. They're like, not the way I love chocolate mousse. But see, that's biological. You know some guys didn't make a sound? It's because we can never derive as much pleasure from food as we can from sex. It's true, it's biological. That's why, see, think of it this way. Say like two people made it and the woman was pregnant. What becomes more important now, food or more sex? Food. Guys are still on the fence about it. How edible does the food get? Guys, if you just made it and someone was present, because we evolved as a species and continue to pass our genes forward, what's more conducive to your survival after impregnating somebody? Food or more sex?
Yes.
You see? No guy will ever rule it out. They're just trying to find a way to combine the two. They're like, can we have food after the sex? That's right. That's why we'll never be able to derive as much pleasure from it. I wish we could. My one friend Stephanie, she's so funny. We went out to dinner and she got the food that she wanted, right? But then she smelled someone with that French toast and she was like, oh, I need to come back and get that. And I was like, didn't you get the thing that you wanted? And she's like, yeah, but like, if I don't get that, like, that's just... I'm like, wait, is that the French toast that got away? Like, she talked about the way that guys usually talk about that girl they're afraid to talk to, right? Like, okay, too close to home, right? I'm just messing with you guys. This is fun, dude. This is fun. I like that we grew up like when we did. I feel like we're the last great generation. I'll explain why. I was on an airplane. I was in LA. And I flew back. I know it made me sound cool. Whatever. I'll make it something shitty. I was in Oklahoma City. And I flew back. Is anyone in here from Oklahoma City? No, this is right at school? Okay, I'm just kidding. No, come on, I can't rip on Oklahoma. Flint. You gotta take anything you can get, right? I was on the airplane, and this dad with his little kid, like maybe like two or something, and he gave the little kid a magazine from the back pocket, and the kid tried to swipe the images on the paper. Because he didn't understand paper. We're screwed, guys. We're screwed. Like, humans are going to stop existing in a while. Like, I imagine his generation is going to be like, how do we reproduce again? We swipe right? Or like, is that... We're screwed. We're the last great generation. I think it's because I grew up playing board games. Did you guys grow up playing board games? Make some noise again. Come on. All right, this is what we're gonna do. I'm gonna let you do a couple of these. I'm gonna let you shout out any board game you loved growing up, and I'll make fun of that on the spot.
Monopoly, Mousetrap,
okay, all right. Alright. Mousetrap? Do you remember how to play Mousetrap?
No.
No one does. It's because the engine, stupid contraption, it never worked, it's Mousetrap. You're missing one of the 97 pieces, it was so stupid. Okay.
Uno.
Uno, do you remember the point of Uno?
To win.
Yeah.
Ooh, it was not to win. What was the point of it? To screw over your friends so hard that they will never forget that game. I'll lose four games in a row just so I can have that one game where they're like, it's your turn. I'm like, oh, really? We played in blue too, okay. Skip, skip, reverse, skip, skip, draw two, draw four, draw two, draw four. Uno, I'm out, bitches. Like, he's like, you have two cards left. I don't care. I already kicked the table. Shut up. Her Monopoly, do you know how to end a game of Monopoly? Yes, you land on the boardwalk and flip the game board. That's correct. In the rules. In the rule book. These are the steps to end Monopoly. Step one, land on the boardwalk. Step two, flip the game board. Step three, don't talk to your friend for a month because you're stealing from the bank and you know it. Step four. Deserve to lose for being a dumbass and not realizing that they got $5,000 for landing on free parking and you only got $50. Has anybody here read the rules of Monopoly?
Yeah.
You're the only place that has ever said yes. Well, 90% of you have it, so just pretend those are the rules, okay?
Clue.
Clue? You guys remember Clue? So you find a dead body. You have to figure out who killed him and what room with what weapon. So you find a dead body, you have to figure out who killed him, what room, what weapon. So you find a corpse. And I'm like, dude, these bullet holes could have come from anywhere. Do you think it was the rope? The candlestick? Shot by the knife. I was gonna see that. Seeing shot by the lead pipe.
Okay.
And then you had to figure out what room they were killed in. It's probably down the hall. I know. What room you found his corpse? And it should be called Get an Effing Clue, okay? Shoots and Ladders about going to sort of the board game, okay? And they're like, everything's going great! Now it's terrible. Why? Because I rolled a four. It's Tuesday. There's no reason. Just sprinkle some Delphi. It evens the board game out. Sorry for that one. Cards Against Humanity. You played that as a child growing up? Did you? No, you played Apples to Apples growing up. The terrible, less fun version of Cards Against Humanity. Apples to Apples was fun because you were trying to play it like terrible people. Did you guys ever play? Yeah. You have an adjective, you have to play the noun you think best describes it. So you always try to be terrible. You guys ever play with people that like don't get the point is to be terrible?
Yes.
Oh my goodness. I played with like family once and they just were like, it was the adjective was like happiness and something sunshine. And I was like, oh my god. There's a card that would always win. Do you know what it was?
Hitler!
Ooh, wow, learned a lot about this audience. Hitler always wins! Second history. No, it was the Helen Keller card. Hold on. You guys are so ready for this to be offensive. I was playing after a show one time in Connecticut. I played after a show. The student group that booked me, and it's parents to light candles. Really? I have to light candles? Okay. I'm kidding. It's not Lady Bob, but you know why? Because it tells you what he wants you to do. Don't know. Lady Bob is probably too polite and doesn't want you to know that you're not doing it correctly and just really hopes that you get it right, but you don't, and they're just really dissatisfied. Then you gotta take it to dinner to turn it back on again. Like, here's the Some of the girls are like, yeah, that would work. Thank you. Please do that. Be thoughtful. Oh, man. How are we on time, Chris? Think we're good? Okay, I want to show you something that I have. I have a couple special things for you guys. And Chris, if you want to come out, we can start setting up the chair so I share this with them. Guy that answered over there, I got your koozie for you. By the way, if you want to buy a koozie, they're $5. But this one's camouflage. It says, drink what drink? This is clearly a tree. It has little tree emojis. You can write your name on it. So I'm going to trust you guys. Pass it back till the guy that deserves it keeps it. All right, but I have something for everybody. There are these awesome little slap bracelets. So after the show, if you want to hang out, I will have these. They say funny things on them. So like this one says hashtag awkward. So if I could see, that's what you do with them. You bestow them on people rather than saying it. So like here's a fun one. Here, you gotta give this to your friends.
Oh,
it says sasshole. So if someone's being, someone's being a sasshole. Oh, she figured out who deserved it. Hot Mess Express, you want to take that with you? Can you not? That's a fun one. Hashtag cat lady. That's always a fun one. Oh no, don't point at her. Oh no. You know what? Okay, so I like dogs, that's why I don't like cats. Because like, it's such a double standard, like a dog bites someone once and you put it down, but a cat claws your face for 15 years and that's just Snuggles being Snuggles. That's bullshit. Who named it Snuggles? It doesn't snuggle. Here's a fun one. I'll give it to you. You ready? It says adopted. That's a fun one. That's a fun one to do. I also have things like Twerkosaurus or. Ooh, I'll give you this one. You now have all the Ebola. Do you want to give it back? You can't. You have it forever. You can give it to other people, though. And then the favorite of the slap races, they're all different funny things, like Sassmaster or hashtag whipped. Here's a fun one that says, you're the father. That's cool. You know what's funny? I did a show at a Catholic school in Buffalo, New York. And there was a priest in the show. And I walked up to him, and I was like, the results are in! You're the father! That's funny! Because I'm so ready to be offended. You're like, that's accurate! That's his title! It'd be better if I gave him, you're not the father, wouldn't it? He'd be like, what a weird way to be fired. By someone who doesn't work here, being a slap bracelet. Figure I'd get a phone call, okay. And then if you're feeling extra saucy, I have a shirt. They're one for 22 for 30. They say, bop it, twist it, pull it, pull it, pull it, pull it. And the bag says, that's what he said. Yeah, but thank you guys so much. You have so much fun show ahead of you. This is just, this is a warm-up. This is